One night as the wind whispered eerie tales, and the stars danced to and fro, I dreamt of the land where my forefathers trod in those times of long ago. In Boston Harbor I saw brave men, and I watched with youthful pride when they scattered the tea in a tax-laden sea to a dark and an angry tide. I wondered then, as I watched these men who flouted King George's might, would Redcoats' hordes with their glittering swords wreak vengeance in the night? Then a voice rang out in the starry air, "Stand fast, young man, be brave. Far better to die 'neath an open sky than to live like a cowering slave." In the early dawn on that April morn, I stood on a mountain tall, and I felt the shock of a musket shot that started first freedom's call. My spirit soared, and its thunder roared, and I prayed to the blazing sky to bless the hand of that gallant band who carried our banner high. In that shifting scene of my wandering dream, I rode fast to Bennington town. General Stark and his Green Mountain boys were camped on the dewy ground. I gazed for a while, and I saw his sad smile. Then he softly said to me, "Their young blood will stain this Vermont plain before our land is free." I remember that smile as I rode each mile. In my heart a dreadful chill, the blood and the sweat and the smell of death rising high over Bunker Hill. The men and the boys with their sightless eyes who lay dead before their time when they broke the chain of King George's reign in a place they called Brandywine. Then clear upon the cold night air I heard a suffering cry. A ragged band of hungry men were slowly shuffling by. Across the valley grim and bare I heard the bugle blow, and the bloody beat of the torn feet staining the virgin snow. In that shivering scene of my nightmare dream, a tall man spoke to me. He looked grey and old in the crippling cold, but his eyes were bright and clear. He said, "Listen, well, then you must tell of the deeds these men have done, and future days will sing their praise from dawn till the setting sun. Tell them of Saratoga, where our patriots fought and died, of Valley Forge and of Paul Revere, who made that midnight ride, of Cowpens and King's Mountain. Don't let them soon forget Patrick Henry's immortal words, 'Give me liberty or death.' Remember the Swamp Fox Marion, who led a wily band of Allen Green and Sumter, who made a noble stand. Remember too the mothers true, who cried their tears alone. Their names will be told with the brave and the bold where'er our flag is flown." He left me then, but I saw him again, standing high near Yorktown Bay. I saw Cornwallis surrender his sword on that bleak October day. Then the tall man turned and he said to me, "Young man, our fight has just begun." And like a flashing scene I awoke from my dream, and I cried in my silent room. On my way to school I felt like a fool, as my childish tears did flow. The things I had seen, they were all in a dream. You see, they'd happened long ago. Then I cast my eye to a building high where our flag was floating free, and I smiled to the sun for the men who had won a nation for you and for me.